Hey guys, welcome to another data structure tutorial. Guys, before starting with the video, there are a couple of points that I want to tell you. First thing is that you make sure that you subscribe to my channel. Second thing, make sure that you watch this video completely to understand this, because I'm going to explain this video in complete details, okay, with the help of an example. So make sure that you watch this video completely. Third thing, that if you like this video, and only if you like this video, then make sure that you hit that like button. Okay, it helps the other students to understand that this is a genuine video. Okay, so without further ado, let's get started. Today we are going to learn with Dijkstra's algorithm, a tutorial by QuickCS. Okay, so first we'll learn the basic concept. What is Dijkstra's algorithm? Dijkstra's algorithm is an algorithm for finding the shortest path between the nodes in a graph, which may represent, for example, road networks. Okay, so basically you are finding the shortest path from point A to point B. Okay, for example, you want to go from, let's say, city A to city B, and there are, say, four ways, okay, going through four different cities. So you want to find out which is the shortest way. So for that, you are going to use Dijkstra's algorithm. The algorithm exists in many variants, but the original one had shortest path between two nodes. Okay, so this is the basic concept of Dijkstra's algorithm. Now, history about Dijkstra. Dijkstra thought about the shortest path problem when working at Mathematical Center Amsterdam to demonstrate the capabilities of new computer called ARMAC. His objective was to choose both problems as well as an answer that would be produced by a computer that non-computing people could understand. Okay. He designed the shortest path algorithm and later implemented it for ARMAC for a slightly simplified transportation map of 64 cities in the Netherlands. So this is the history of Dijkstra. He originally did it for his own computer called ARMAC. Okay, and then later he implemented it for a road transportation map for 64 cities in Netherlands. Alright, now let's take a look at the algorithm. First step in the algorithm is what? Let the node at which we are starting called initial node, okay, and let the distance of the node y be the distance from the initial node to y. Okay, now the extra algorithm, we assign some initial distance values, okay, and we'll try to improve them step by step. Then the second step is mark all nodes unvisited. Okay, so you make sure that you mark all the nodes are unvisited, you are starting fresh. Okay, create a set of all the unvisited nodes called unvisited set. So you create a separate set of it. Third step is assign to every node a tentative distance value. Okay, set it to 0 for our initial node. So basically, say you want to go from city A to city A, obviously the distance is 0. Okay, and infinity to all other nodes. So basically you don't know, so you are currently giving the maximum value available, that is infinity. Okay, so for the current node, consider all its unvisited neighbors and calculate their tentative distances through the current node. So basically what you do is you start from the current node, okay, and all its unvisited neighbors, what you do is you calculate their tentative distances. Compare the newly calculated tentative distances to the currently assigned values, okay, and the assigned the smaller one. So basically, let's say you have point A and you previously had a distance, say, infinity as we had started, but later you found out the distance to reach there was like, say, 4 kilometers. Okay, now 4 kilometers is less than infinity, so you replace infinity with the shortest one, that is the 4 kilometer one. So this is step 4. Now step 5 is, when we are done considering all the neighbors of the current node, mark the current node as visited, because we have visited this node and all its neighbors. Okay, and remove it from the unvisited set. Now a visited node will never be checked again. So basically, if you have another, you are checking the next node and this node happens to be its neighbor, but it is already checked or unvisited, it's visited, then you don't check it again. Okay, now step 6, move to the next unvisited node with smaller tentative distances and repeat the above steps with check neighbors and mark visited. So you repeat the same steps for the next smallest unvisited, okay, node. Now if the destination node has been marked visited, guys, let me make one thing clear. Now you might be thinking that this explanation of this algorithm is very complicated, but when I'll explain the example, you'll understand it really easily. So don't worry, these are just the algorithm and steps that is necessary, or I have to explain it to you but with the help of example you will understand it better. Okay, so step 7, if the destination node has been marked visited, that is the final node where you want to be, okay, if it is marked visited, then you stop. Okay, and the smallest tentative distance among the nodes in the unvisited set is infinity. Okay, now what happens is, alright, now I'll explain it with the help of example, you'll understand it better. Now see, this is our source node X, this is our destination node Y. What was the first step? Mark all the nodes as unvisited, they are all currently unvisited, yes? Okay, now you mark the distance from source or the initial one as 0, okay, so we assign 0 to the initial node, that is the source node, and to all the rest of the nodes we assign infinity. We have done that, yes. Now what we do is, from the source node we check the neighboring nodes. Okay, what are the neighboring nodes or connected nodes of the source one? C and B. Okay, what are the current values of C and B, or the distances required? Weights infinity, infinity. Okay, now we'll check for C. Okay, what is the weight or the distance from X to C via this route? It's 2. Okay, now is 2 small than infinity? Yes. So we assign the newer value, which is the minimum one, which is 2. Now similarly we do this for the B also. Okay, now 4 is smaller than infinity? Yes. Okay, so we assign 4. Okay, now we are done with both the neighbors or whatever the neighbors were there for X. Okay, so what we do, we mark it as visited, as we have seen. Okay, now once it is marked as visited, we'll check which one is the shortest one out of this. What is the value of C now? 2. What is the value of B? 4. Which is the shortest one? C. So what we do, we draw the first step of our shortest path, that is X to C. Okay, now next thing is, we'll check the connected neighbors of C. Which are the connected neighbors of C? B, D, E. Yes. Okay, so we'll start with E first. Okay, for E there is one route like this. Okay, what is the weight if we go by this route? It is 2 plus 10, which is 12. Is 12 less than infinity? Yes. So we assign the newer value, that is the less one, which is 12. Now similar thing we'll do for D. 2 plus 8, because we are finding the distance from X to D. Remember, we are always counting from X. Okay, so don't think that it is 8 or it is 10. It is actually 2 plus 8, 2 plus 10. Okay, so X to D, what is the current value via this route? 2 plus 8, 10. Okay, 10 is less than infinity? Yes. So what we do, we assign 10. Now the next neighbor for C is B. Okay, 2 plus 1, that is the distance from X to B via C, is 3. Is 3 less than 4? Yes. So what we do, we assign the shortest value, that is 3. Now all the neighbors of C are visited, connected neighbors? Yes. B, D, E. X was also its neighbor, but it was already visited. Okay, so we never check it again. Now all the neighbors are visited, so we mark it as visited. Done. Now what are the current values of all the unvisited nodes? B has value 3, okay, D has value 10, E has value 12, and Y has value infinity. Okay, so what we do is, we take the shortest one. Which one is the shortest one? 3. Okay, so we connect our shortest path, second step, to B. Alright, now for B we check which are the neighboring nodes or connected ones. X is there, C is there, D is there. Okay, X is already visited, so we are not going to consider it. C is also visited, so we are not going to consider that also. Only D is left. Okay, now currently to reach D from X via C and B, what is the distance coming to? 2 plus 1, that is 3, and 3 plus 5, 8. Okay, so 8 is less than 10? Yes. So we assign the newer value, which is 8. Now all the neighbors are visited for B? Yes. So we assign it, you make it as visited, mark it as visited. Now check the values of the remaining unvisited nodes. For D it is 8, for E it is 12, and for Y it is infinity. Which is the shortest one? 8 or D. Okay, so we connect the next path of our shortest path, that is B to D we connect. Now from here, which are the neighbors of D? C is there, E is there, and Y is there. Okay, C is already visited, so we don't care. Now Y and E are left. Okay, now next step is, you check for Y. Okay, you have reached to D. Now from x to y, what is the distance y at d? It is 8 plus 6, which is 14, right? Is 14 less than infinity? Yes, it is. So what we do, we assign the new value, which is 14, okay? Next thing is, you check for e, okay? To reach e from x via d, what is the value we get? 8 plus 2, 10, okay? Is 10 less than 12? Yes, so we assign the new value now, which is 10, okay? So all the neighbors of d are visited, yes? So you mark it as visited, okay? Now the shortest path is the node which is revealing, which is having the least value, which is e or y, 10 or 14, which is the shortest one? E. So we connect next shortest path, which is e. Okay, now e has only unvisited node, which is y. Okay, what is the distance from x to y via e, okay, or via c, b, d and e? What is it? The value to reach e is 10 and plus 3, which is 13. Now is 13 less than 14? Yes, so you assign the new value now, which is 13. Okay, now all the unvisited neighbors of e are visited, yes, so you mark it as visited. And the shortest path to reach y is also found, which is 13. Okay, so you mark y also as visited, because there are no unvisited neighbors of y, so you mark it as visited. Alright, so we have found our shortest path to reach from x to y, and the value of that is 13, that is 2 plus 1, 3 plus 5, 8 plus 2, 10 plus 3, 13. So that's how you find the shortest path with the help of Dijkstra's algorithm. Okay, so guys, if you have any doubt, I mean any doubt, feel free to ask in the comment section below. If you have been having any confusion, make sure that you watch this video again. Okay, I have explained it really slowly and properly, but still, if you have any doubt, watch this video again or ask me in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to help you. Okay, if you really like this video, hit that like button. Okay, share this video with your friends who are struggling with this concept. Okay, and make sure that you subscribe. That's it for today, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe.